All right, we're going to do our second video on segment postulates. On this one, we're going to focus on using a number line. And so just a reminder of our segment addition postulate and our midpoint addition. Segment addition postulate was the simple idea that if I have a segment, that it's the idea that the first part of the segment plus the second part of the segment would be equal to the length of the whole segment. In the example I used in the last video, that if we had a length of 3 and a length of 5, the entire segment must have a length of 8. That's a duh thing. It's obviously true and doesn't have to be proven. That's why we call it a postulate. And then we also talked about the midpoint definition, which is the idea that B is the midpoint of this segment. It means the point that's perfectly in the middle, such that, you know, this part has the same length as this part. And so we're going to continue to use those ideas here in this slide, but we're going to focus on using number lines. So this says, what is LM? Now, note, whenever it's referring to a segment, but it doesn't put the little bar over it, it's talking about the length. So this is another way of saying, what is the length of LM? And so there's really a couple of ways of doing this. We could do strategy one, would be just to kind of count. Okay, for this problem, it's pretty easy. Our first strategy would just be to count. And I see that if we start here, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this obviously, LM obviously has a length of 7. Now, our other strategy is that to find distances, and this gets a little bit hairy whenever we start talking about negatives. It gets a little harder to visualize. But our other strategy is to subtract. Okay? So, for example, if I took this minus this, it would give me the length. I think it's a little bit easier to visualize. Let's say I had this segment, and let's use some positive numbers. Let's say here's 0, let's say here's 4, and let's say here's 10, and I wanted to know the length of this segment. Well, you could do 10 minus 4, and it would give you the length of that segment, the length of the entire thing minus the length that you don't want, okay? Now, that same idea works here. It's a little bit harder to see with the negatives, but basically I can do 4 minus negative 3. I can do 4 minus a negative 3, and when you're subtracting a negative, remember, that means you are adding a positive. So the length, when I subtract, I still get a length of 7. Next, let's look at how we can do midpoints with these. So midpoint can be thought of a couple different ways on a number line. It can be thought of a couple different ways. So once again, let's look at two strategies. I'll do one over here to the left and one on the right. So strategy one, I don't know if I really have a name for this strategy, but to find the midpoint, I can just really take the average of the two points. So if I took the 8 plus 40 and divided it by 2, that would give me 48 divided by 2, or in other words, 24. Okay, so we know that the midpoint here is going to be 24. You may have been able to get that on this problem just by looking at it, but it's helpful to have a strategy for when the problems are a little more complicated. Now, let's learn a different strategy. A different strategy would be to actually, strategy two, let's find the length of the whole segment first. So just like on the last slide, we found the length by subtracting. So the length of this segment, so PQ, could be found by doing 40 minus 8, and we find that our segment in question actually has a length of 32. So this distance is 32 units, okay? Well, if it's 32 units, then half of PQ, one half of the segment would be 16, okay? And so what we could do is I could start at P and add 16 units, or I could start at Q and subtract 16 units. If I start at P and add 16 units, that would get us halfway there. That would get us to that 24. If I started at Q and took away 16 units, that would also get us to 24. So there's just a different way of thinking about it. You could just take the average to find the midpoint, or you could find the length of the segment and add that length, or and add half of that length to the first point, or subtract half that length from the second point. Either way, no matter how you do it, you should end up at that midpoint. Now, let's practice. So what is KL? Now for this one, I'm just going to use one strategy here. So for the length of KL, I'm going to subtract. So KL is going to be 15 minus a negative 9. Be careful, don't lose a sign in there. that's really just 15 plus 9, or 24. So the length of KL is 24. What is the coordinate of the midpoint of KL? Now, a couple of different ways of looking at this, but one way of doing it would be to take the average of the two points. If I do negative 9 plus 15 and divide by 2, that's going to give me 6 over 2, which is really 3. So the location of 3 right there, that's going to be the midpoint. Our other way of thinking about it would be to say, okay, well, if the entire segment KL has a length of 24, then half of KL would be 12. So I could start at point K, which is negative 9, and add 12 units to get to my midpoint of 3. Or I could start at L and subtract my half the length of my segment of 12 units and end up at 3. But no matter what strategy you use, you should get that the midpoint there is 3. Now, here's where it gets challenging. This says point C lies between K and L. The distance between points K and C is 1/3 of KL. What is the coordinate of point C? Well, we established on the last slide that the length of KL equals 24. So therefore, 1/3 of KL would be 24 divided by 3, which would be 8. So what I know is that segment KC equals 8 units. And so what I would do is I would start at negative 9, and I would add 8 units to it. That's going to get us 1/3 of the way to KL. And so if I do negative 9 plus 8, I'm going to end up at a location of negative 1, which is right there. That's going to be point C right there. Okay? Now, I'll go ahead and mark it on here. Next, it says point N lies between points C and L. Okay, so now we're finding some other point N that's somewhere in here, and I'll switch colors for this. Some other point N that's in here somewhere. The distance between C and N is 1/4 of C, is 3/4 of CL, excuse me. Let's first figure out the length of CL. Okay, CL, to find the length of this segment, you can just take this point minus this point. So we do 15 minus a negative 1, and we find that CL is 16. Therefore, this question is involving 3/4 of CL. So we know that 3/4 of CL would be 3/4 of 16. If you took 16 and multiplied it by 3/4, you would get 12. Okay? So the distance between C and N is 3/4 of CL. So what we do is we know that if the entire CL is 16 units, 3/4 of the way there would be 12 units. So if I started here and I added 12, that should get us to point N. So if I start at negative 1, which is point C, and then I add the 12 units, which is the length we want, I end up with 11. That tells me that if I come back up here, that our point N is at 11. Okay? So these problems, these number line problems, are a little bit harder because I realize that my work isn't that great. It's really just a lot of using your intuition, okay? There's not a set of formulas that we always use. I try to give you a couple of strategies, but I really just want you to think creatively about these problems. Draw a picture when you can, and you'll do great.